Assalamualaikum and a very good day to you all. In this video, I would like to share with you on how to differentiate a mixture of trigonometric, exponential and logarithmic function. Okay, so by the end of this video, you should be able to differentiate functions involving trigonometric, exponential and logarithmic function. Okay, so let's get started with the first example over here. Okay, now to differentiate this function, okay, so we have to adjust this a little bit because these two can move over here, right? Okay, so y will become 6 ln 2 plus 5x over 3 plus 4x. So for this one, the next step is that to apply one more logarithm rule, okay, whereby if we have log a over b, it should equal to ln a minus ln b. So we are going to use this over here, okay. So afterwards, y equals 6, okay, 6 bracket. We have to put bracket because we are going to separate the terms into two different logs, okay, because they share the same number in front of the log, so we have to put a bracket so what we have is ln bracket 2 plus 5x, okay, minus ln 3 plus 4x, this one, okay, close. Then, this one, we just merely adjust the form of the function. Not yet differentiate. Okay. And then afterwards, what we have to do, we have to expand the 6 back lah. Okay, so y equals 6 ln 2 plus 5x minus 6 ln 3 plus 4x. Okay. And then we can differentiate. Yeah. dy dx equals 6 multiply 1 over 2 plus 5x multiply by differentiation of the bracket. This thing lah. We differentiate. 2 differentiate 0 plus 5x differentiate with respect to x is 5. Okay. Minus 6 multiply 1 over bracket 3 plus 4x multiply by the differentiation of the bracket. We differentiate 3 becomes 0. Okay, we differentiate 4x with respect to x is 4. Okay, and then we follow through, simplify them. Yeah, so 6 multiply by 5 is 30. Okay, over 2 plus 5x. Okay, minus 24 over 3 plus 4x. So this is the differentiation of the question. Yeah. Okay. So this is the first one. Let's consider the second one. This one. Okay. So for this one, okay, this is almost the same form, okay, except of the power. Okay. So this one we can change it to y equals ln 2x plus 3. Put a bracket to avoid confusion. Minus ln 5x plus 7. Okay, so from here we can find the differentiation. So dy dx equals 1 over 2x plus 3 multiply the differentiation of the bracket. So 2x is 2 plus 3 differentiate by with respect to x is 0. Yeah, minus this one. We want to differentiate it. 1 over 5x plus 7 multiply the differentiation of the bracket. So 5x differentiate with respect to x is 5 plus 7 we differentiate with respect to x is 0. Yeah. So therefore we get 2 over 2x plus 3 minus 5 over 5x plus 7. Okay. So this is the answer for this one. Yeah. Okay. Now let's move on to the next one. Okay. Maybe, okay, maybe I move this exercise first. That's better. Okay. The exercise for you to do later, not now. Eh? Okay. Now, differentiate y equals 3 ln x over x squared plus 5 by using quotient rule. This one we cannot run away. We cannot apply the logarithm rules that I've done before. This time we have to use quotient rule, the one that me and you hate so much. In order to consider quotient rule, the numerator must be u, okay, denominator must be v, and then we do lah over here dy dx, dy dx. Okay, I do the fraction really big like that. Okay, du is d dx. What is u? 3 ln x. Okay, and then multiply by v. V is what? Oh, put multiply. Later confused. Multiply. Okay, v is what? X square plus 5. I don't want to confuse. Put bracket. And then minus. Differentiate what? V. Differentiate v is x squared plus 5. Okay, and then multiply by what? By u. U is what? 3 ln x. The line is not enough. Like that. Make it longer lah. We have the denominator as well. Don't forget. V squared. Okay. So I suggest no need to expand the v squared lah. Okay. Because most of the time, we might cancel it out with whatever we have in the numerator. Might but not always. So let's solve this one by one. So this one is 3 over x. Okay, multiply by this one just like that lah. X squared plus 5. 5. Okay, minus. We will simplify later. Okay, this one is 2x. Okay, multiply by 3 ln x. 3 ln x. This one, just leave it be. Too big. Suddenly power 5. Quite sorry. Okay, now, I scroll it down, leave it down. Okay, so this one what to do? Easy. So, it's 3x squared plus 15 over x. Okay, minus 6x ln x. 6x ln x, because we multiply this one, right? Okay, and then over, maybe I change the everything over to this one. Maybe I put a bracket, like that, and then multiply 1 over x squared plus 5. That's better. Okay, now what to do with this one? We have to make it nice as a one fraction, one big fraction. So, what to do? This one is over 1. So, we have to multiply by x. Multiply by x to make it equal with this one. So, multiply by x. This one also multiply by x. Multiply by x. This one no need to multiply with anything because over x already. Okay. So, 3x squared plus 15 over x minus 6x squared ln x over x. Okay, and then this one just copy paste lah. Just copy paste. Okay, that's better. Okay, this one we can group them together. Okay, we can group them together. 3x squared plus 15 minus 6x squared ln x over x multiply 1 over x squared plus 5 squared. This one what to do? Just multiply numerator with numerator. This one. And denominator with denominator. This one. So, no need to do anything else. Just copy paste everything. 3x squared plus 15 minus 6x squared ln x. And then this x we put, cannot put inside because we have square over here. Just put it outside. So, x multiply by x squared plus 5. So this is the answer. Okay, so thank you for your time and attention. But before you dismiss, okay, before you dismiss, please do this exercise to practice what you have learned throughout the video. You may pause the video to take the screenshot of the question. Yeah. So I think that's all. Thank you for your time and attention. Assalamualaikum. Have a good day.